to be powerful or not to be powerful. The question is, do you want to be powerful? Because if you do, you have to either do two things. Do at least years and years of vast amounts of research and study on subjects and ancient cultures and years of meditation looking inwards, which is the whole bundle of straws, as you would put it, or two, find someone that is already in this process and ask them to be there for you and guide you through this process, in all honesty, because there is something that has been hidden from society and the world's population for hundreds and hundreds of years, and has been purposely swept under the rug and purposely having people give rational explanations for ancient cultures, symbols, and structures around the world. And the true subject of matter here is, to be really powerful, you must follow the oldest traditional cultures that actually achieved this. Jesus did it. Ezekiel did it. Enoch did it. And Moses did it. But now the question is, will you do it? Will at least a third of the world do it? This, and I doubt very much, but there will be a small number of people that will do this. So come with me as I take you on a journey of what it means to truly gain real power. And it all is derived in the self. The 100% genuine and original identity of you as a person, without your car, without your house, without your possessions, that is the secret. Looking inward and expanding your mind to higher levels of consciousness that hasn't been touched for over thousands of years. But the question is now, can you do this? That's why I welcome you to my new audio blog, Osiris978, to be powerful or not to be powerful. Your destiny is your choice. The difference in taking advantage of this divinity within is all solemnly up to your free will. Thank you very much.